kid surprised when I tell him there's only one core left. I shouldn't have believed it either. The memorial. Here, a kid can pay respect to the old world and earn it in kind. The valediction. Just another one of my sketches. Nothing more. Words can't express what happened, but they're all I got. We track the final core beyond the city to the wilds. The wild unknown. Place can eat a man alive. Place is so raw, even the Calamity couldn't cook it. Not all of it. Know what's better than having to sling a pistol in a fight? Heaven too. Savage things lurking at every turn. Kids faster than a slinger with those guns. Pin cushions ain't the worst of it either. Pecker's got the core, like they're building a bastion of their own. The welcoming committee scrambles to attention. Didn't expect the kid so soon. They shouldn't have let their guard down. Getting that core was one thing. Getting out's gonna be another. He digs his way out of the clearing, but the wilds won't let him go without a fight. Wallflowers survive the calamity. Best take it real slow when pincushions are afoot. Slinger Jawson's old outpost is all that's left of him. A handful of windbag shipments made it out this far. Don't ever turn your back on a pincushion. Kids roused up half the wilds by now. Then kid gets the feeling he's being watched. Not by me, by a lunkhead. And lunkheads ain't fond of two-legged animals. Hit him anywhere but the hindquarters and he only make him mad. The Calamity must have scrambled their eggs. Hardly any signs of the old Jawson camp. The Wilds already reclaimed this place. He's anxious to get back. After all, he's got the final core. His journey's over, right? Well, no, it ain't. Not by a long shot. Kid knows something's up when we ain't there to give a warm welcome. See, Zulf and I were just wrapping up a heated discussion. Zulf can barely muster the words. The Calamity failed, he says, but I will not. And with that, Zulf leaves us here, alone. Zulf cursed the city, cursed the Bastion, cursed me, said he was going home. When Zulf got through reading that journal, he just snapped, started smashing up the monument till I tried to stop him. Zulf banged up the monument pretty bad. But there's a way to put it back together. The shards. We're gonna need all of them to nurse the Bastion back to health. After Zulf's little episode, Kid sets off in search of shards. First stop, Jawson Bog. You'll get lost in that bog, I told the kid, and I won't be able to guide you back. Well, I let him go. What else could I do? What could any of us do? Zulf put us in a real bind. Hurt the Bastion bad. But the shards can make it better. They're like smaller doses of the core's medicine. Shame the only place to fill that prescription is out here in the wilds. This place is intoxicating. Don't know where he's gone. Might be gone for good, for all I know. Wherever he is, he's somewhere I've never been. Somewhere I never want to go. Thank you. dead welcome him with open arms. Kid pops him good. That a survivor? No, ma'am. It's a lonesome ghost of a gas fella. Say to a kid who's seen too much. I'm Zulf of Eura. Pleased to make your acquaintance. Now the kid sees something stranger still. Did anybody else survive? Sure enough, he finds peckers, lunkheads, wallflowers, pincushions, vine apples, swamp weeds, ankle gators. Sets foot inside one of Ceylandia's famous watering holes. The security's just gonna have to straighten him story is supposed to start at the beginning. It's so simple with this one. Now here's a kid whose whole world's all right, snoozing there on a rock in the sky. He wakes up. I'm just fooling. He sees what's left of the rippling walls. Years of work undone in an instant. He sees what's left of Pith the Bull. Gods, they're all undone. He sees what's left of his lifelong friend. His friend, he's come undone too. He sees what's left undone. Do 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 do. thought we'd lost him, but he finally comes to. The shard ain't lost either. Not anymore. Now to find a ticket out of this hole. Bootlickers dig their nasty thorns into his heels. Ever heard of a lung blossom? It's bigger than the stories say. The breath on that thing, like a scumbag sprung a leak. They say one whiff of lung blossom can make you lose your mind. Well, a kid prunes it down to size somehow. Mother only knows what happened in the bog. Kid never much cared to speak of it. A shard is like a poor man's core, but beggars can't be choosers. That's it. A few more shards like that, and we'll be back in business. A single shard can breathe new life into this place. The shard's got enough juice to spruce up any of these places. Black rye like hot pineapple chowder on a cold day. Brings back memories. The city tried to use the shards to stake out the wilds. So much for that plan. Ankle gators used to roam the wilds, and they nested at Rothus Lagoon. Many a tale folks used to scare their children straight originated here. All kinds of beasts what don't know up from down still lurking about. They move quick and quiet, and they struck hard. Even the brushers learned to fear this place. They used to think that ankle gators were extinct. Well, they ain't. One of them's been living in the tall grass. Turns out Queen Anne got a hold of a shard. Ankle gators love shiny things. Brushers use their pikes to keep their distance around here. Now the kid can do the same. They say you can't hurt an ankle gator unless it's raining. And it ain't raining. Most of those peckers are smart enough to stay out of Queen Anne's way. Can't get hasty in a place like this. Sharp sticks make Queen Anne nervous, so she backs off a bit. Those pincushions have been living off the ankle gator scraps. Queen Anne can't fit down some of these narrow paths. Queenie leads the kid into some kind of twisted trap. One bad step in that tall grass and he's Queen Anne's lunch. He holds his ground. Seems the queen's running out of options. Still no sign of the shard. The closer you get to an ankle gator's lair, the thicker the tall grass grows. Kid's gotta make a run for it. Those leaping lunkheads don't like Queen Anne any better than the kid. Bad idea to walk in gator grass. Seems even stinkweeds know to stay away from the queen. Queenie must have scared a bunch of peckers out of hiding. Ankle gators don't much care for their young. That's why there ain't many around. Wanna know how to find an ankle gator lair? You use a kid as bait. The shard's sitting in plain view. He's got it, and now to finish her off. Now she's coming for him. She's got nowhere else to go. She's starting to get annoyed. And now he's made her mad. Rest in peace, Queen Anne. That was for the brushers. Kid's done what needed to be done. Queen Anne's reign is over. We even got a crown jewel. They said Queen Anne was just a folktale. Now there's living proof she ain't. That gator's a crazy gal, but so is the gal who promised to look after her. His bow's looking lean and mean like a prize fighter. All that trouble for a single shard, but you know what? It was worth it. The memorial may be finished, but our part is far from over. The faith. Mother, this one's for you. The next shard should be farther out there in the wild. Know how Ceylandia became the richest city in the world? Two words. Point Lemaine. If the wilds could ever be tamed, it was gonna happen right here. But now, the greatest outpost past the city line is nothing but a freak show. The army's triggers once had the place on lockdown. Kid might as well pick up where they left off. Point Lemaine seemed better days for sure, but it ain't done. Whole place shudders in a fit. The grand rail of Point Lemaine, not only is it still there, it still works. Of course, it's no longer shipping hides and alloys and spices. But it can give the kid a lift. Just as long as he can stay clear of the trouble on the tracks. Grand rails all grown over with things of calamity chewed up and spat out. Things eager to take back their turf. You don't let so much as one of those things slip by. Lunkheads settled in like they owned the place. Takes fancy footwork on the rail, what with wallflowers, coffin, fungus everywhere. Place used to be closed off, but now it's split open like a rotten pineapple. Of course, the Grand Rails seem much more fighting than bygone times. Near on, 50 years ago, first shots fired in the Ur-Ceylonian War. It was right here that Zulf's Ura forefathers decided to mix it up. Okay, so maybe we didn't get their sign-off on the whole Grand Rail thing. That was bad. The rail must have shook the Ura to the bone down in those dens of theirs. Well, the rail won't last much longer now that the kid took the shard. It's still got one good run in store for him, though. All the rotten wood there on the rails turned it into Swamp Weed Central. Ever tried dancing side to side while holding your breath? While choking on swamp weed? While peckers trying to prick you in the eye? Well, let me tell you, it ain't fun. Then, at last, it's the end of the line. He'll be picking swamp weed out of those boots for days. Turns out he's got company up at the rail station, waiting for him. Not just another wallflower, pincushion, mind you. At first, he thinks it's Zulf. Turns out he's wrong. "This is for you," says the man. Then wham. When the kid comes to, the man's long gone, but something else is there. The only words Kid recognizes on that parchment are for Zia. Well, what's a kid to do? He took the shard, he took the hit, and he took that note. That note cuts straight to the heart of things, don't it? It ain't too late to unlock the potential of this place. Zulf's messenger was one of his people. Wonder just how many of them survived, and what exactly Zulf told them. Ain't saying much, but that's the greatest forge in all the city. Finding gourmet ingredients ain't easy these days, but we'll take what we can get. The note says it plain. Zia, go east to learn the truth about the Calamity and our people. I'll be waiting. Sincerely, Zulf. Shards are getting harder to find. Not everything blew up in the Calamity. Why, Colford Cauldron here blew up way ahead of its time. The cauldron boiled over some 300 years ago. They say it filled the skies with ash and the lakes with molten rock. If you wanted to survive something like that, you had to learn to adapt. So in a way, the beasts of the wilds, they're all survivors too. It takes a certain stubborn pride to keep on living in a place like this. As for us, we learned an awful lot from Colford Cauldron. That learning led to some interesting inventions. The raw power of the world fell right into our hands. Playing with the cauldron's fires became an addiction. Sure, we dusted off a good many secrets out here, but we discovered other things we're better off not knowing. It's awful hot in there. The unforgiving scent of sulfurous dirt. The taste of air so hot it sticks to your lungs. All sorts of awful things crawling underfoot. You can cook those things, but you can't eat them. Never thought we'd find so much life in all that ash. The more ash we swept aside, the more life we found. We kept on sifting through the cauldron's secrets anyway. Place is inhospitable as they come. But still we pressed on. After all, when we looked down inside Colford Cauldron, looked down through all the smoke and flames, we saw in there the heart of the world, the heart now laid bare by the calamity. We had to have it. As for the kid, he just has to get that shard out of there. Too bad taking that thing woke up every last stink eye from here to Jawson Bog. Biggest stink eye he's ever seen is waiting for him on the other side. Well, it ain't polite to stare. Where there's one stink eye, there's always more. The cauldron's tenants all gather up to bid the kid a fond farewell. Kid don't shed any tears for him, though. With a good spyglass, you can still see the cauldron from the city. But all the fires died out. There's nothing left of it. It comes back looking like the inside of a chimney. He put some finishing touches on the business end of that thing. They said the wild could never be tamed, if only they could see us now. We're all a little short on friends these days, so that's a welcome sight. The shard works like a charm. You can hear the monument's heartbeat again. We need an awful big lost and found under the circumstances. Culture, a still life of old unwanted keepsakes. we spotted a pecker carrying a shard to Mount Zan. Can't rightly call Mount Zan the mountain anymore. There's no more mountains now. There's no place left for the beasts of the wild to go. Good thing for those beasts the Calamity saved leftovers. We only found their little lair because they found themselves a little shard. Creatures of the wild, they've been building a bastion of their own. But they ain't yet prepared for any company. Best thing we can do for those beasts right now is put them down quick and clean. Besides, we have to take back what's ours. Even if the beasts of the wilds won't like it. Look at it this way. It's either them or us. But if we win, they win too. Our bastion is everybody's game, not just ours. Unfortunately, there's no explaining that to a simple beast. Those beasts have been hard at work fixing up the place. They've rounded up their survivors, just like we have. They've been searching for cores and shards, just like we have. Maybe they've thought about turning back, just like we have. We just really need their shard. Kid got it fair and square. That's the way. He's done what's best for him, don't you worry. Don't you worry. We'll all be better off once the bastion is complete. The monument's getting better. Zolf sure did a number on it, though. The arsenal's complete, in case we need protection.